大家好，歡迎大家收睇新一季嘅《藝方星期天》，我係 Billy 李志芬。今集節目咧，一班爵士樂迷咧就大飽耳福啦，因為咧陣間第二節有重返香港嘅瑞典低音吉他手 Richard Mumpson 嚟到我哋嘅錄影廠，今次咧仲帶埋歌手 Vivian Buxack 上嚟為我哋獻唱已故著名爵士樂歌手 Ella Fitzgerald 嘅歌曲。不過咧，首先同大家介紹美國歌手 Stacey Kent。他熱愛演唱經典的爵士樂歌曲，歌迷遍佈世界各地。其中一位呢，還是諾貝爾獎小說家石克一雄。石克一雄還為他寫過幾首歌。Stacey Kent 和演奏息事風的丈夫 Jim Tomlinson 現時在倫敦居住。他曾經灌錄過11張專輯，亦都推出過大量的現場演唱會唱片，唱片總銷量超過200萬張。Stacey 演唱的歌曲很多元化，由美國的經典名曲、個人創作，以至法國歌謠、巴西音樂都有。在剛剛過去的星期一， Stacey 就在香港舉行了一場演唱會。S'il n'y passe jamais personne, pourtant chaque parisien, il n'y a que les aventures. Sometimes your relationship to a song grows even more intense and stronger, and sometimes it fades away. There are songs that have literally sat on top of my piano at home that I've always, you know, really liked.But never felt like I needed to sing them. And then I will literally say to Jim, we'll be, you know, playing something. Jim, my husband, my producer, my saxophone player, will be home playing. And suddenly it can be almost as dramatic as this. I need to sing that song. I can only give you love. Stacey Kent 在新澤西州長大，她從小學習鋼琴，而且小小個就熱愛唱歌，還喜歡不同種類的音樂。她早期喜歡的音樂包括爵士樂薩克斯風手 Stan Getz 和歌手 Sean Shabato 的作品。Of course the jazz was very important to me, but I think that the person who made the most impact on me as a kind of melancholic 14-year-old was João. Because João's, and I speak Portuguese, but I didn't speak Portuguese at 14. I only spoke French at 14. So I was locked out of the lyric he was singing, and yet I totally felt like I understood what he was saying. And what I heard was this voice that was quite sad, quite reflective, quite wistful.雖然 Kent 熱愛音樂，但係佢大學時期喺薩拉羅倫斯學院修讀比較文學。畢業之後，佢去英國入讀市政廳音樂及戲劇學院。喺嗰度，佢認識咗佢嘅丈夫同音樂上嘅拍檔息事風手 Jim Tomlinson。佢哋1997年合作推出首張專輯《Close Your Eyes》，之後仲合作咗好多其他專輯。
We grew up together in this music and we came from such different places. He's English and I'm American. We had different musical backgrounds. And yet, so we had so much in common in terms of our universe, in terms of our sensibility and our desires musically. And yet we had such different backgrounds that we each brought very different elements to the relationship. So that was great. And that still goes on today, even after all this time.
Close your eyes.
Close Your Eyes 收录了经典作品和较少人认识的歌曲，是1997年英国最畅销的爵士乐专辑。时至今日 ，Kent 的曲目包括 Tomlinson 和其他作词人的作品，当中包括诺贝尔奖得奖作家石克一雄。夫妇二人和石克吃午餐的时候，三个人就决定要合作。石克为他2007年第八张专辑《Breakfast on the Morning Tram》入面的四首歌曲填词，主题包括回忆、游历和爱。
They set you in a dreamscape. And you don't know what's real, and you don't know what's a dream. And Ishiguro does this in his writing as a novelist, too. And he does this for me, I think, also because he's the kind of person he sees me as.When Jim Tomlinson started writing with Kazuo Ishiguro, the songs for me that started making their way into my repertoire, I really felt like I had found really the right kind of repertoire for myself. When I would go back to the standards, which I will never stop doing, suddenly something like I've grown accustomed to his face felt even more potent. So I think that the mixing of the repertoire has been really important to me.Les amours
perdus ne se retrouvent. 因为热爱音乐，令 Kent 学习咗多种语言，包括法文、德文、意大利文同葡萄牙文。佢话中意法文系因为佢祖父。佢细个嘅时候，祖父会读波特罗尔嘅诗作俾佢听。在2010年，他推出全法文专辑《Requiem Moi》，当时他的音乐已经在法国很受欢迎。亦因为中意巴西音乐的关系，所以他学习葡萄牙文，用葡萄牙文去唱歌。他2011年去巴西结识了其中一位 Bossa Nova 的代表人物，作曲家及吉他手 Norberto Maniscalco。2015年，他们合作专辑《Tenderly》。
I'm a huge fan of their music, and they have really made me sing the way that I sing today.They bring me back to that time because they know how much I love that music and they really want to share everything. It's all over now.
You've been gone before. 在他最新专辑《I Know I Dream》The Orchestral Sections 入边。亦首度同58位音乐人合作，不过佢话无论有几多人一起合作，佢嘅音乐入边亲密嘅感觉好重要。
Mine is a very intimate one. I really love to tell a story. I love to be inside that lyric and tell that story. Yes, I'm playing jazz, of course, because the harmony, the chord structure, all of that is based within this foundation of jazz, and yet.I also feel very close to the folk singers because the conveying of a story and the telling of a story is so important. It's not like there's just a groove and it doesn't really matter what the words are.
巴勒斯坦藝術家 Mona Haktoum 在黎巴嫩首都貝魯特出世和成長。1948年阿拉伯以色列戰爭之後，一班巴勒斯坦人流亡去到黎巴嫩，他們在黎巴嫩一直受到冷眼，不受歡迎。 Mona Haktoum 亦都不例外。雖然他現時在倫敦居住，不過仍然熱切地關注戰爭後的各種傷痛和苦況，例如有很多人流離失所、痛失家園，被迫遷往他國，所以他透過藝術創作，例如是裝置、多媒體作品、雕塑等等，去探討政治和人民之間的矛盾。這些作品大部分都加入了日常的物件，有時更加令人會產生不安的感覺。Mona Haktoum 在香港的首次個人作品展現時正在白立方畫廊舉行，展期去到11月中。 歡迎翻嚟第二節嘅藝方星期天。瑞典爵士樂低音吉他手兼作曲家 Richard Malmsteen 上過嚟我哋節目好幾次，咁相信觀眾對佢咧一啲都唔會陌生。Richard 曾經喺香港居住多年，經常帶領海外嘅爵士樂歌手嚟到香港演出，咁特別係嚟自瑞典同埋北歐地區嘅歌手。幾年前佢翻返去瑞典家鄉，但係咧不時都會帶埋佢嘅音樂人朋友嚟到香港，俾本地嘅爵士樂迷認識。今次咧佢就帶咗一隊 band 上嚟，咁當中咧包括主音歌手 Vivian Buczak。今日我哋好開心咧，邀請到佢哋兩位嚟到我哋嘅節目現場啊，同我哋傾偈同埋表演嘅。
Well, Richard, it's a delight to have you back in our studios. Thanks for coming in. You've been responsible for bringing in so many of the best and brightest Swedish talents and also from other parts of Scandinavia as well. Can you just please run through who we've managed to get into our studio
right.
this week?
And hi, Ben, and it's great to be back here. It feels so good. Well, today I've been very fortunate to have a great singer with us, Vivian Buczak, from the south part of Sweden, close to where I'm from. We have... Peter Asplund on flugelhorn today, and the legend Klaus Krona. And we're very fortunate to have Andy Gander, who now lives in Hong Kong. And hopefully he want to play more with my projects when I come by town.
Vivian, I'll start with you. Why don't you go through some of the highlights for you and what have you been up to recently?
Well, I'm always up to different things, but I've been working with these guys. This was the first thing I did in my whole career in Sweden. That was working with Klaus and Peter. And I'm so happy to be here in Hong Kong with them, therefore. But in Sweden, I do different projects with other musicians, of course. I've recorded some albums, both with Peter and Klaus and with other musicians. And what's coming up now is a big band project way up north, in the northest part of Sweden, where the ice bears are running on the streets.
It's always fun for vocalists to sing with a big band, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, it is. It's quite a challenge. You have to have the power in your voice.
And now, Klaus, you have a performance with all these folks on Thursday.
Yep.
What sort of material do you expect you'll be playing on Thursday?
We'll be playing mainly parts from our CDs, what we have been doing, yeah. I would say. Songs of our lives and live at the Palladium.
Yeah. Mostly original music or mostly your
mixed,
own versions of
very
classics?
Mixed, actually.
Uh-huh, mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Andy, it's a delight to have you back in Hong Kong. And what's it like to be able to sit in and mix in with folks from Europe and all over the place?
Yeah, it's a great pleasure playing with these guys. These are serious musicians, great professionals, great artists. And only just meeting them, but it's easy to work with them and really, really looking forward to the concerts.
You know, small group jazz is such a specialized and niche sort of item, but it does seem to have this global appeal as well. And it's also a very flexible format. So what are your thoughts on this as a format or as a medium for music?
If you look at the jazz history, the small group is sort of the center of the whole thing. And also it's like a conversation you have around a table, like a dinner table. You say that, I say this, and you respond, and you listen, and you come up with another story and things like that. It's like the center of what I like to do as a musician, because then you get the right connection with all the different players.
And as a singer in a intimate setting like this, how does that differ from say, your big band project you mentioned previously?
Oh, I love singing with a small group. Big band is another thing. Like Peter said, everything is set from the beginning and you know what to do and the form of the song is set. But singing with a small group and the improvisation is a freedom for us. I mean, we always have the song as a frame, but inside of the frame, it's like a picture where you paint and you mix colors and you come up with different thoughts and different ideas every time you play the song. The song is never played the same way you go on stage, and that's why we love jazz, because it's a free interpretation every time, and the freedom of it.
If there's any sort of interesting projects in the pipeline or some highlight of something coming up that you'd like to talk about that people might be able to access either online or catch next time you come through Hong Kong, what would that be?
I would mention something like Stacey Kent.
Yeah.
We were listening to her the other day at Ocean Park, and next month I'm bringing her to Sweden and we are doing a tour, a 9-day tour. I'm looking forward very much to that. Yeah. And it's very funny that she was here the other day and we met her.
What would you like to do for us here in the studio? We've been talking about all this small group jazz stuff. It'd be great to hear some.
We are jazz musicians. We are part of the great American songbook tradition. We love that, you know, all those songs that were written by the big names like Gershwin and Cole Porter and everybody. So we choose this song. It's by Jerome Kern. And since we are jazz musicians, we are also rebels. So we try to change everything, you know, to do it our way. So we took this beautiful major key ballad and turned it into a minor key samba. And it's called Dearly Beloved.
I'm looking forward to it.
Dearly beloved, oh my.